Costa Concordia from the rocks off the Tuscan island of Giglio, 20 months after the cruise ship capsized with a loss of 32 lives. The team in charge of the unprecedented operation will begin at dawn tomorrow at a cost of £600 million, as Porrick O'Brien reports.
Even 20 months on, the site of the Costa Concordia, just lying there so close to the beach, remains as incongruous as ever. 32 people lost their lives when it ran aground. Over the months, an enormous salvage operation has built up around the ship. 500 engineers, £500 million, all gearing up to tomorrow morning at dawn. And the largest maritime salvage project in history.
And everyone's pretty excited and
overseeing it all, this man.
An incredible plan has been achieved, and we look forward to making sure that we power buckle as soon as we can. So I think everyone's very energized and looking forward to it.
The ship ran aground off the island of Giglio and came to rest on a narrow ledge. It's 300 meters long. First, they had to make sure that the 114,000-ton wreck didn't slip into deeper waters, so they made an enormous base from concrete and sandbags that would eventually serve as a sort of mattress for it to rest on. Huge hollow boxes called sponsons were then fitted to the port side. Then they were fitted with hydraulic jacks and connected by cables to the underwater platforms. In a process called parabuckling, the cables will be gradually tightened to pull the ship upright. If everything goes to plan, it should be righted within 10 hours. Sponsons will then be fitted to the other side of the ship and serve as sort of giant armbands keeping it afloat. It'll then be towed to Sicily and sold for scrap. Informing the grandiose engineering, the tragic detail. Two bodies still missing. A ship full of the belongings of those who survived and those who didn't.
Basically, it's a big concern to everyone, especially us and the families. So when we bring it upright, we'll have underwater cameras that will see exactly what's on the seabed, and the authorities will be looking for the missing people. That's one of the priorities.
Five people have now been found guilty of manslaughter and negligence. The trial of the ship's captain resumes next week. The families of those lost 20 months ago, impatient with progress. More than just a ship to be salvaged.
The sport now, and the Olympic champion Mo